whole thing, right?
Okay, okay. Let me come to that. I'll ask. I got your question. I'll answer the question. Okay. So your question is, people say the enlightenment is self because of self effort. Some people say it's because of grace. Okay. Some people. The question is, what is what really leads to self realization? Okay. So you can. I'll give an example. Okay. You can let us say you take a ball in your hand and squeeze it. Okay, so the ball wants to come back to original shape. Okay, so the ball is not comfortable in that squeezed position. So similarly, what happens? The universal consciousness enters into your body. Okay, enters it creates the various bodies, living being, human body, and many other bodies. It enters into the body. Okay, the entering of the body by universal consciousness is called Chidabhasa, reflected consciousness.
Okay.
So now, it is like infinite consciousness entered into a finite body.
Uh-huh.
And it is never comfortable with that situation. It is like a squeezed ball. Okay. And why does it enter? It wants to experience the world. For experience the world, its only way is to enter the body. Okay, I can give the body as a similar to, okay, you go to a 3D movie, and you wear a goggles, and you start seeing 3D characters. Without wearing the goggles, you cannot see the 3D characters. And at the same time, if you want to enjoy the movie, you have to forget your home, forget your office, everything. So you get involved in the movie. Similarly, universal consciousness forgets that it's universal consciousness and enters into human body as jiva or individual consciousness. And this in the Vedantic language is called Chidabhasa. So now, in this situation, first it has to forget that it's universal consciousness. Otherwise, it cannot experience the world. So it starts experiencing the world. But somewhere deep down in consciousness, there's a feeling that I am infinite. Okay? Where is the deep down the feeling, there's a feeling, I am infinite. This this congestion of the body or limitation of the body is not for me. So that feeling is there deep inside. Okay? Now, it has come to experience the world in the form of body. It can be any body. It can be a monkey's body or a donkey or a dog or human being.
Right. Okay.
Okay. It is constantly looking for happiness because happiness means infinity.
Right.
Okay. So it starts looking for in the objects of the world.
Right.
Okay. It is like a hide and seek game. I am finding myself in the world.
Right.
So whatever you try to do, you cannot get it.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Correct? You understand? So, now, there's a lot of effort goes into this finding.
Right.
Finding what?
Happiness.
Finding happiness means finding myself. Because I am happy. I am infiniteness, infinite consciousness. My nature is happiness. That means I am trying to find myself in the objects of the world.
Right.
Okay? So now, and this is a real game of hide and seek. You have forgotten yourself and you're trying to find yourself. And no matter what you do, you cannot find yourself in the objects of the world. Okay? So this is called self-effort. You are trying to find yourself. So there is a self-effort involved to find yourself. And that self-effort is, ultimately it leads to frustration. Nothing will happen. So is there a self-effort involved? Yes. For what? In the happiness, which means finding myself. So the self-effort goes on, and it comes to a stage of total frustration. So there is a self-effort involved to find myself, okay, one level, that's at the individual level. Okay, at the same time, there's a deep inside consciousness, there's a feeling that I am infinite. My nature is, this situation is not acceptable to me. Okay, who is saying that? The in the memory of being infinite consciousness, the deep memory. Okay? There are no two. There's no individual, there's no universal consciousness. Same universal consciousness has appeared as individual. There is no two. Okay, don't think that there are two, there is a split happened. Okay, it's like an elephant, an infinite elephant has entered into a small body.
Okay.
So now this elephant is not comfortable in that body.
Right.
But it doesn't know that it doesn't know that my nature is infinite. It has forgotten to enjoy the body.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, at the same time it has a memory that it's not okay for me.
Mm.
So there is a pull. Okay.
Mm.
The pull is again the deep memory of infinite consciousness. I am infinite consciousness, that pull is there. This pull is called grace. Okay, the pull is called grace and the pull is there right from the day one. Okay, there is a tremendous pull. Okay, I am infinite. I want to be happy. I want to be happy all the time is the pull. Whose pull is that? It's not no other somebody is not sitting above and pulling it. It's only universal consciousness has appeared. Okay, it has taken the body and now universal consciousness has a vague memory of I am infinite. Okay, and that vague memory is pulling it back. Okay, you understand? So there is a pull. Okay, the pull is being exerted constantly by the universal consciousness. Okay, what is the pull? I am infinite, I am peaceful memory. Okay, so now this pull is called grace. Okay, so there is also a struggle which goes on at the individual level. I want to find happiness. Okay, now happiness is being searched outside. Okay, you'll never find it and you'll ultimately come to a frustration. So now you cannot come out of the situation because the individual has completely forgotten his universal consciousness. Okay, but somewhere deep memory is there that I am universal consciousness. The pull is going on constantly. Okay, so at that time, okay, he requires a instruction or guidance for liberation. Okay, now he is frustrated with the objects of the world, and by good fortune, by good merit, he finds a realized master. Before finding the realized master, he may go through so many other masters also. And everywhere he will get something and finally he comes to a conclusion, this doesn't work for me. And finally he realized realized master. Now who is the realized master? One who has realized, he himself is Brahman. That means he has become free. Okay? So, the individual meets the universal consciousness in the form of master. The master is no longer individual. Even though he appears in a body, he is not an individual. He is the Brahman only. So, there are two pulls now. One is pull happening from inside. And master comes and he pushes from outside. Okay? So, he pushes him from outside towards the self. So there are two actions happen. The pull from the universal consciousness and the push from the master. So this pull and push is called grace. Okay, now, okay, so the question is self-effort required? Absolute self-effort is required. Okay. To a point to frustrate, to find out the limitation of self-effort. Okay? Because he doesn't remember the universal consciousness, he doesn't know the master also. So, what is the purpose of self-effort is to find the limitation of self-effort. Okay? So, that means without self-effort, nobody can get enlightened. Okay? And when the self-effort is almost exhausted, he finds the master who will push him inside. That is called grace. Okay, so now I want to summarize. Okay, the self-effort, the purpose of self-effort is to find the limitation of self-effort. Okay, the grace is pushing you inward from outside in the form of master, and pulling you from inward from the point of your universal consciousness. So the push and pull will take you to the self. Okay, I want to summarize it very clearly. Okay, self effort. Nobody got self enlightened without self effort. Okay, nobody got enlightened without self effort. At the same time, because of self effort, nobody got enlightened.
Right.
It's a paradox.
Right.
Are you now? Is the question answered for you? Can you repeat the question more clearly?
The question is that it appears that things every jiva ultimate destiny is realization.
Correct.
But the way in which each jiva actually travels is not probably defined in a clear cut way. This is as if things are little loose, and it is up to the jiva to decide which path he has to travel based on his own conditions and surroundings and all. So is that true? To explain this, I'm giving an example. So it looks like, for example, from Hyderabad to Bangalore, the destination is fixed. Now the jiva in Hyderabad is trying to go to Bangalore, which is Brahman. Now, the way I take the route probably might differ, but the journey, the one has to travel the journey and the destination is fixed. So now do an individual jiva has a choice in deciding his journey.
So first, the analogy is not right. Okay, Bangalore to Hyderabad route and analogy of self-realization, the analogy is not correct.
Okay,
because Bangalore to Hyderabad, there is a distance. There is a time and space. Okay?
Right.
So the spiritual journey is not in the domain of time and space. Spiritual journey is from domain of time and space to no time and space. Okay?
Right.
So it's not a journey at all. Okay, it is not a journey in that sense. Okay, because there is no distance to be traveled. So there is a recognition to be done where there is no journey at all. So there is no path at all. A path is involved when there are two points where there is a gap. Between individual consciousness and universal consciousness, there is no gap. So there is no path.
Right.
It is a pathless path.
Right.
Okay? It is not, there is no path at all. So the example of Bangalore to Hyderabad journey is not applicable to spiritual journey.
Okay.
Okay, now having said that, many people say that I am going through a spiritual journey.
Right.
Okay. It is actually the journey in time and space they call a spiritual journey.
Right.
Okay? Which has nothing to do with spirituality.
Right.
Okay, what they are trying to find, no doubt everybody is in spiritual journey in that sense.
Right.
Everybody is looking for happiness.
Absolutely.
And happiness is spiritual.
Right.
Okay, so now the jiva has lost himself in the body and mind complex. Okay, and he doesn't know way out. It's like a getting lost in a maze. So he is trying. He doesn't know. He is blindfolded. And who has done blindfolding? He himself has taken that option to experience the world. Just like you have taken an option to go to a movie and buy a ticket and get into the movie, you have taken an option. And to go to the movie, you have decided that I'll forget my family, forget my office, and I'll go to the movie. So Jiva has taken an option. Now he has come and got lost in this movie. So it is a maze, okay? So in this maze, he doesn't know how to come out. So he tries all possible means, marriage, success, car, everything he tries. But what he is trying to find out is happiness only. Okay, it is trying to find himself only. It is a spiritual journey only in the matter. Okay, then he is frustrated. Okay, so then he says, I will go to temple. In the temple also, he is looking for an object. He is not looking for the self, Atma. Okay, then he goes to a guru who teaches him yoga. Oh, he is still in the time and space. Okay, then he goes to somebody who teaches him pranayama. Okay, until a point of time, when he meets the realized master, okay, who gives jnana, the wisdom, okay, in Vedanta or the teaching of Vedanta, without a jnana from a realized master, you cannot get enlightened. Okay, jnana is not a journey. Okay, jnana is a jump.
Okay.
There is no journey. It is, okay, it is a jump. The best I can say, example I can give, somebody is dreaming. Okay, dreaming, he is sleeping in the bed. Let's say you are sleeping in the bed in Hyderabad. And you are dreaming that you are roaming in the forests of Amazon forest. You are lost. You are searching in the Amazon forest. Where is my home? Okay, so you keep asking somebody. Okay, this somebody who gives you guidance, direction, this direction, that direction. They are called gurus. Okay, then you are lost. Still you don't know. You are asking many gurus and many people show some different ways and every way looks beautiful. The journey is in still what you are doing is dream only. Then finally, due to good fortune, you come to a realized master. Then realized master tells you, hey my dear, you are dreaming and you are searching for your home in the Amazon forest, which is dream. And you wake up. Now he wakes up. He is waking up a journey.
Not thinking, but in the mind probably it is there.
No, that's not a journey. Waking from a dream to waking state is a jump. It's not a journey.
Okay.
But till you come to that point of time, you are journey. You are doing journey. But the journey is in the Maya, in the dream world, in the time and space. Strictly speaking, it's a spiritual journey because you're looking for happiness.
Right.
Reality is, you're not looking at happiness at the right place.
Right.
So the right place, when the moment you recognize the right place, the journey is over. Okay, the jump has taken place.
Right.
So the jnana, I don't even call it journey. It is a jump.
Right.
So everything which brings you up to the point of jnana, the wisdom, is a journey. But the point is that journey is in the time and space. Okay? It is a spiritual journey because you are looking for happiness. But it is not a spiritual journey because you are looking for happiness in the wrong place. Okay? So now you tell me, how many paths are there for spiritual enlightenment?
Only one.
There is no path. You have to just wake up. It's a pathless path.
Right.
But to come to the pathless path, you have to go through many paths. You have to go through a maze. And none of them are in the reality.
Right. Yeah, this brings to my next question.
One minute. Can I? Hello. Can I break this for a few? Let's say another half an hour or so. Because I have some visitors. Okay.
Sure.
I'll give a call to you. Then we'll continue.
Sure.
Okay.